are the position of maxima and minima. So again, this is your source which is emitting the monochromatic light, and this light is emerges out from here, and this is your slit which is having a size that is equal to capital small a, and a screen is placed at a distance of capital D. Now I want to find out the position of maxima or minima on this screen. So I take this P is a point where I want to calculate maxima, or we will apply the condition of maxima or minima. So to calculate the maxima or minima, we have to calculate the power difference. So first, the light coming from this A and the light coming from this B. To find out the position of maxima or minima, we should first calculate the power difference. So what is the power difference? So that is path difference. So here from this diagram, the light coming from A and light coming from the B will have the path difference, that BB minus AP. Now see here, either you calculate by using applying Pythagoras theorem or simple by another method. So here I am using another one method. So here I am dropping a perpendicular from A on BP. So I have drawn a perpendicular, choose. This size of slit is very very small as compared to the distance of screen. So as the size A is very much less as compared to the capital D, so we can say that this AP distance is nothing but it is CP. So which implies that AP is nothing but it is equal to CP. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? अगर मुझे तो पार डिफरेंस निकालना है, तो AP is equal to CP हो गया, तो the light coming from the B will have only this much extra path. So this will be your path difference. ये होगा आपका path difference. That is, so now the path difference will be only BC. So I will calculate the path difference, that is BC. So if you take this triangle A, B and C. So in triangle ABC, so what is sine theta? So sine theta will be equal to how much? So sine theta is a perpendicular, that is delta x divided by hypotenuse. This is our hypotenuse. So hypotenuse is equal to this A. So what should be the power difference in that case? So which implies that the power difference will be equal to A sine of theta. Difference. Now I want to explain the central maxima and the secondary maxima separately. So I am not going to follow the same rule as we used to do in the Young's double slit experiment. So let's discuss about the central maxima here. Why this at center the maxima is obtained, and why its intensity is maximum as compared to the all maximums. But for that to explain it, I divide this illumination or this slit AB into two equal parts, that is AC is equal to CB, or any source in this AC section, there exists another one source in this CB section which will have a path difference equal to zero, or which will have an equal path or path difference equal to zero. For example, suppose a light coming from this source which is at A having a this much path, then we will have another one source in this CB section. I take any one of it, but I will choose that one which will have an equal path. So similarly, since C is a midpoint, so if a light coming from this B part or B section or B point, then both this path will be equal. If the both the paths are equal, then the path difference, let's say delta x, will be equal to zero. So फॉर एवरी सोर्स, कोई भी सोर्स चूज करो इस सेक्शन में. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई विल चूज हियर एट द मिडवे. सो मिडवे से इस पॉइंट से अगर लाइट गई टू द पॉइंट ओ, और ये अगर मैं कोई एक पॉइंट ऐसा चूज करूं जिसका पाथ डिफरेंस या पाथ इक्वल हो, सो दैट विल बी आल्सो एट द मिडवे ऑफ सी बी. तो दोनों का पाथ सेम है, इक्वल पाथ डिस्टेंस. So path difference again equal to zero. So we can say that all the sources in this AC section will interfere constructively with the all the sources in the CB section to form a maximum on this screen. Since all the sources interfere constructively, so a maximum intensity is obtained. Maximum intensity is obtained at the center, as you can see from this experimental graph. Central maximum, now the secondary minimum. So we call this is a secondary minimum. All the minimums are referred it as a secondary minimum. Let us assume that the light coming from A and B have a path difference of lambda. दोनों के बीच में path difference कितना है? Lambda. That if I draw a perpendicular, this much length is extra covered by the light which is going from B. So this I take this length as a lambda. So then I divide this AB slit into two equal parts. Mean to say that AC will be equal to CB. Then the distance or a path difference for A to C will be how much? If the path difference from A to B is lambda, then the path difference from A to C will be lambda by the path difference for A to C will be lambda by 2. Now, for this case, if I choose any one of the source from this AC section, कोई भी source choose करूं इस AC section से, there exists another one source in this CB section, which will have a path difference equal to lambda by 2. So, whenever your path difference is lambda by 2, then it is a minimum. For example, see here, suppose the light coming from this A and the light just below, or it is coming from C. As we know that the light coming from A and C, which will have a path difference of, in dono ke beech mein path ka difference kitna hai? Lambda by 2. So, the light, these two sources will interfere here destructively. As a result, form a minimum. Similarly, if I choose another one source just below the A, so there will be another one source just below the C, which will again have a path difference of lambda by 2. Is section se gayi, is point se gayi light, or is point se gayi light? Both dono ke liye path difference kitna hoga? Lambda by 2. So they will interfere destructively. So all the sources in this section, कोई भी source ले लो इस AC section में, there exists another one source in this CB section which will have a path difference of lambda by 2, and it interfere destructively. When path difference is lambda by 2, then it is minimum or interfere destructively and form a minimum. So when the path difference is lambda, then we obtain a minimum on the screen. Let us suppose the light coming from A to B and the light coming from B to B have a path difference of now 2 lambda. So I divide this slit into 4 equal parts. One, this as a C2, and this part as a C3. Now light coming from A to B and from B to P have a path difference of 2 lambda. So I divide this slit into 4 equal parts such that each part length, the light coming from each part length from edges will be, the path difference will be equal to lambda by 2. In those sections say ke beech mein se source se light jab jayegi, so we'll have a path difference of lambda by 2. C1, C2 से source से light जाएगी, तो इनके लिए path difference lambda by 2. C2, C3 के लिए जाएगी, तो इनके लिए path difference lambda by 2. C3 और B से जब light जाएगी, B, P तक पहुंचेगी, तो they will have a path difference of lambda by 2. So, if I choose two sections, अगर मैं कोई एक source choose करता हूँ, A, C1 से, इस सेक्शन से कोई सोर्स चूज करता हूं, देयर विल बी अनदर वन सोर्स इन दिस C1 C2 सेक्शन व्हिच विल हैव अ पाथ डिफरेंस ऑफ लैम्डा बाय 2. फॉर एग्जांपल लाइट ए से गई और C1 से गई, तो ए और C1 के बीच में पाथ डिफरेंस कितना है, दैट इज लैम्डा बाय 2. सो कोई भी सोर्स चूज करूं ए C1 से, देयर विल बी अनदर वन सोर्स इन दिस सेक्शन व्हिच विल इंटरफेयर डिस्ट्रक्टिवली. So, this whole illumination of this A to C2 will form a destructive interference, means minimum. Similarly, in dono ke beech mein bhi same case appear hota hai. That is, koi ek source choose karo C1 C2 section se, there will be another one source in C3 B section which will have a path difference equal to lambda by 2. So, when the path difference is lambda by 2, then it is minimum. So, all the sources which will interfere from to B will have a path difference lambda by 2 or interfere destructively and to form a minimum. Similarly, if I choose a path difference 3 lambda by 2, so again you will find that I divide this step into 6 equal parts. So, each part will cancel out with each other and form a destructive interference. So, what do you observe from here? So, we observe that. So, it is observed that the light coming from A or from B, if they have a path difference lambda, 2 lambda, 3 lambda and so on, 4 lambda, you will find that we will have a minimum. We have a secondary minimum. So, this is, if you generalize this thing, so it is coming out to be this N lambda. So, here N is 1, 2, 3 and so on. So, whenever your path difference is integral multiple of wavelength, then we will have a secondary minima in the case of diffraction experiment, single slit diffraction experiment. So, we have already calculated the path difference is equal to A sine of theta, compare it. So, it is A sine of theta is equal to N lambda. So, from here you can say that sine theta will be equal to N lambda divided by A. So, if angles are very small, as our screen distance is very, very large, so this theta will be equal to N lambda by A. So, where N is changing from 1, 2, 3 and so on. Now, if you, this is your, the angular width. So, this is your angular displacement. So, if you want to calculate in terms of position, so we multiply it by d, theta multiplied by d. So, what you get? It is n lambda capital D by a. So, this is your position of minima on the screen. So, if your angle theta 1 is equal to lambda by a, so then will be your first secondary minimum when angular displacement. And if your angle is, this angle is 2 lambda by a, then will be have second secondary minimum. So if you want to calculate the position, this y distance, so you can see here y is how much? The y will be equal to arc is equal to theta into radius. So what is the distance of this slit from the screen? That is capital D. So here yn is equal to theta into radius. So theta is what? N lambda by small a. So capital D we have multiplied it. This is your position of first, these are the position of secondary minimas. If I put that mark on the screen, position of first minima will be equal to lambda by a, lambda capital D by small a. And the secondary minima is obtained at 2 lambda capital D by small a. Similarly, on the negative side, so it will be on the minus lambda capital D by small a, and it will be minus 2 lambda capital D by small a. Now, let us discuss about the secondary maxima. So, what are the other maximums? So, to explain it, so I have drawn these two single slit diffraction experiments. So, first one, let us, for this case, the first one case, let us suppose the light coming from A and the light coming from B at point B have a path difference of 3 lambda by 2. So then I divide this AB slit into 3 equal parts. So I take this as a C1 and this as a C2, such that each path length is lambda by 2. Means the light coming from A and the light coming from C1 have a path difference lambda by 2. Similarly, the light coming from C1 and C2 have a path difference lambda by 2, and so on for C2 and B. Now, if I choose any one of the source in this AC1 section, there will be another one source in this C1 C2 section which will interfere or which will have a path difference lambda by 2. For example, light coming from A and the light coming from C1 will have a path difference lambda by 2, as I have already chosen is lambda by 2. So they will, path difference is lambda by 2, so they interfere destructively and form a minimum. Similarly, all the sections, all the sources from AC1 interfere destructively with all the sources with C1, C2. So, form a destructive interference. So, this part of the slit is get diminished or form a minimum. And the third and the, this part, it appears as it is on this point P and illuminate this P point and form a secondary maxima, as shown by this graph. Similarly, if I suppose the path difference is 5 lambda by 2, then that is the light coming from A and the light coming from B have a path difference, and I divide this slit into 5 equal parts, AB into 5 equal parts, such that each part length is lambda by 2. Means light coming from A and light coming from C1 having a path difference lambda by 2. Similarly, for C1, C2, the path difference is lambda by 2. Similarly, C2, C3 and C3, C4 and C4 and B have a path difference lambda by 2. Now, for any source in this AC1 section, there is another one source in this section which will interfere, which will have path difference lambda by 2, then it form a destructive interference. Similarly, this part form a destructive interference at this point. So, forms a minimum, or this part does not contribute towards the illumination at point P. Similarly, for C2, C3 and C3, C4, for any source in this C2, C3 section, there is another source in the section which will interfere destructively and the minimum. So, because of this section of this slit, there is no illumination. And only this fifth part, which is left at is. So, this part, which is from C4 to B, this part is left, and this part does an illumination on this point P, and the maxima is obtained on this, and it is shown by this graph. So here you can see that here third part of the screen contributes a maxima, So that is why its intensity is less as compared to the central maxima. Similarly, in the second case, here the fifth part is contributing towards the maxima. Means if the slit is this much, only the fifth part is contributing toward the maxima. So that is why the intensity is keep on decreasing as we go to the higher order of maximas. It is observed that when your part difference is 3 lambda by 2, 5 lambda by 2 and so on, there will be a maxima in the diffraction single slit experiment. So if you generalize it, so this becomes 3, it is 2n plus 1 and it is lambda by 2. So either your the path difference is equal to odd integral multiple of half of wavelength, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Now we have already calculated the path difference in the single slit diffraction experiment, that is equal to a sine theta. So comparing it, so we get delta x is equal to a sine of theta and it is also equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. So we want to calculate its angular separation, so that sine theta is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 into a. So here you can see that if the angles are small, that is the screen distance is very much large as compared to the size of slit, then this sine theta can be replaced by theta. So the angular separation for a secondary maxima is found to be 2n plus 1 lambda by 2a. Now if you want to calculate this angular separation in terms of linear separation, so we have to multiply it with by t. So theta into t. So put a value. So you get 2n plus 1 lambda by 2a into t. So this is your linear separation of this screen. Suppose this is your screen and this is your origin. This y, the distance of a point from the screen, this distance is your y. This y is a linear separation from the center of the screen, tells that if satisfied this relationship, then it forms a secondary maxima. So if you want to calculate first secondary maxima, so put the value is equal to n is equal to 1. So n is equal to 1 is 3 lambda by capital D by 2a, literally the second one secondary maxima, so 2 to the 4. So it is 5 lambda capital D by 2a and so on we can calculate. If you put these figures on this graph, you will find that first secondary maxima is 3 lambda capital D by 2a. So it is first, this is your center one, this is your first maxima, that is 3 lambda capital D by 2a. Then on the either side, it is minus 3 lambda capital D by 2a. So this is how we can represent the position of a maxima. So we have discussed that the central maxima is having higher intensity and its fringe width is 2 lambda capital D by small a. If you calculate the fringe width of this section, it is found to be lambda capital D by a. This means that central fringe width is twice as compared to the fringe width on the secondary maximas. And if you see comparatively, that intensity dies out exponentially in the diffraction, single slit diffraction experiment. So this is your all about this much. Thank you.